Good morning, it's Jeannie. Welcome back to my channel, and I really thank you for supporting it. And always remember, thumbs up, share, and subscribe. I am a wellness advocate. I like to tell the stories of events that happen in my life, past and present, hopefully future, because we all have a bright future. And yesterday was my birthday, and I think it was a very eventful day. I am 73 years young and still going on. I have had many achievements and many failures in my life, but I always feel blessed. I always have. I don't know where this feeling of blessings came from, other than my stepfather Johnny, who instilled a lot of gospel into my life, a lot of reasons for the seasons and things like that. Just kind of looking over my notes, it's early in the morning, it's not even 6 o'clock yet, but I'm off to the flea market. And you know, there's days I haven't liked my life at all. I know there was one time in my life, even though my life was full, life was tough, and I did not want to live past my 25th birthday. And on my 25th birthday, I kind of looked out the window, and the flowers were blossoming, and I remember looking at the red ant bed, and they were busy, and it kind of changed my life, and kind of started looking forward to things. God blessed me with children early in my life. I was weak in my responsibilities. My first child, I really did her wrong. She forgave me. She loves me. My second child, I tried to correct all of my mistakes. She has forsaken me. My third child, he died. My fourth child, he is so smart. He was a Marine, made me so proud. Life has been unfair to him, but like me, he keeps on keeping on. I'm very proud of my fourth son. My fifth son, I will always believe I did right by him. I did him no wrong, and he hates me. He hates me to the core. My sixth child, no, he's not my favorite, because I love all my kids the same, but he's special. He calls me every day, and if he's not calling me, he's texting me. I'm never out of his heart or his mind. He is definitely my joy. But I love all my kids the same. You know, with my second child, I knew I had to change my life. So I did change my life, and I went to better. I went to school for 12 months when I was 26. I learned how to read and write. I went to school 5 days a week. And I was the only one in my class who graduated. And I went on to a major university. I still had my weakness in reading and writing and arithmetic, but it didn't stop me. And I earned a degree in home economics. I worked into the school system for a while. And then I moved on to be a real estate broker. In conjunction with being a real estate broker, I was always also in partnership with a high-risk auto insurance company. When the family changed, the business went away. But I went on to... I went back into the educational system, and then I opened me a bait and tackle shop. Well, not everybody fishes every day. It was a small town, and I would have been the best bait and tackle shop in the state of Oklahoma, and I know it, but life got in the way again. But in addition to having the minnows, I had three sizes of minnows. I had crawfish, I had salamanders. You wanted crickets, you wanted turtles, whatever bait you wanted. I had every stink bait there was, every size of hook I could have. But I also had a kind of like a mini zoo, because I would go to the local distributor to get my koi, and I would pick up cockatiels and lovebirds. And once I tried rats, but they had babies and escaped, so I gave that up. And I had my little jewelry shop. So, and I had a rabbitry, and I was really happy on my land with my husband. But man upstairs called him. Then I moved to Florida, and I was lost for about 6 years, and then I got my land back. Oh, so happy when I got my land back. But the problem is, the people who were there in the 6 years, they totally destroyed my bait shop in my little apartment that I had. And so I couldn't open my bait shop back, which was a very disappointment. And then my ex-husband and his cousin, they helped me open a smoke shop, which was also becoming successful. I can't think of any endeavor that I didn't do that didn't have some degree of success, because I put my heart into my work. Well, life happened again, and here I am back in Florida. Kind of like living a life without purpose. But every Saturday, I go to the flea market, and I meet new friends and things. And then now I'm doing the videos. And I really love doing the videos, and it seems like I always have a smile on my face most of the time, unless I'm talking about sad things in my life. And I don't talk about sad things in my life to drudge up the ugliness and stuff. I have been looking into my past and to see what makes me and what can make me better. I may be 73. But I know that I'm on a new, new life. I got 20 more years. It's a milestone in my life, and that I need to improve. I need to be better. I need to keep my happy smile. My throat is kind of rough, or I would sing the song that I sang for my daddy. Try to remember September. Let me see. Try to remember the kind of September when life was mellow. I can't remember the song this morning, but my throat is struff. But, you know, September is, I don't believe I'm in the winter of my life. I still believe I'm in the fall of my life. Yeah, December's coming. And it's not far away around the corner. But I have a lot of love to give and to offer. And yesterday was so exceptional. I had been waiting all week. I said, my birthday present is going to be my new water heater. Well, the plumber came. He looked at my water heater and he says, 2 weeks, I'm bringing a new one. I have to order it. So I'm going to be 2 weeks more without a water heater. So I paid my co-payment. And I know next month I have to do my air conditioner. But I got a birthday gift that took care of my co-payment. So come Monday, I have that extra money now. I'm going to call and have them service my air conditioner. The first child I heard from was my third born. And then the next one was my sixth born. And all the friends and families in Texas, they called, they wished me happy birthday. It was so nice. And then I went out to eat with my friend. It poured like horrible waiting to get into the restaurant, but it was beautiful. And I had lamb. I really enjoyed my lunch. My birthday was awesome. I got home kind of, I'm so tired, because it was really a full day. And then my sixth born, he calls, and him and his kids, they sing happy birthday to me. So it was a good day. I'm thinking it's one of the best birthdays that I think that I've had with the, I don't know. Maybe I'm just full of love yesterday. Got a little disappointed when I couldn't find my battery charger, but I've misplaced it. It'll show up. But that was the only disappointment I had yesterday. I had my sons, and I had my friend, and I had all my friends in Texas. You know, this is a September I will remember. I can't think of much more to say other than thank you, thank you, thank you for making my birthday great. Love you, and God bless.